It's happening. This is not a drill. I have been waiting 9 years for this moment. Let me explain. In 2022, I got my PhD from Harvard University's Department of Organismic and Evolutionary Biology. I did my dissertation research right here in the Kramer Lab on the genetics and evolution of columbine flower petals. I figured out a lot about how these flowers make their weird and wonderful 3D petals, and I made a lot of videos about my research along the way. But I was missing one key tool in my scientific toolkit, the ability to transform columbine flower genes. The Kramer Lab has finally figured out how to do it, so I'm back at my old PhD stomping grounds to learn how it's done and to finally get some closure after years of hoping I'd be able to do this experiment for my own dissertation research. Let's go change some plant genes.
Hi, Molly.
This is Yan. He is a postdoc in the Kramer Lab, and he developed the protocol for transforming columbine flower genes.
Hi, everybody.
So, Yan, can you talk a little bit about why we want to change columbine flower genes in the first place?
Definitely. So we're in a basic science lab, so we really care about how fundamental aspects of plant development works, like how flower is able to control the shape and color of all their different organs. In order to understand that, we first need a couple functional tools. One is to be able to visualize how the cellular dynamic is, to watch the dynamics under the microscope. We would basically need a marker to track the cells over time.
You want to be able to like light up the cells, so we'd be able to just know what every single cell in the plant is doing as it makes a flower.
Exactly, that's the ultimate goal. And then the second aspect is we really want to be able to control when and where a specific gene is being turned on.
Right, so if I wanted to know like how a certain gene is involved in a flower's development, a really good way to do that is to turn it off and like see what goes wrong.
Yes.
And right now we can't do that.
Yes.
But you just figured out how.
We are trying very hard to make it happen.
You did a really good job. So can we go do the experiment
yes,
now?
Yes, definitely. Let's go. Yes, we are ready to roll. And then today we're going to use aqueous seedling grow on the media.
Aren't they so cute?
And then for today's transformation, we're going to use agrobacteria.
So you've met agrobacteria many times in my previous videos. This is a bacteria that's naturally evolved the ability to transform plant genes.
Agrobacteria is able to insert its own genes into a plant's DNA, which instruct the plant to make food and housing for the bacteria. But scientists can swap out the house and food genes with genes that they want to study, and the agrobacteria will insert those genes into the plant DNA instead.
So Yan, what genes are we giving the columbines today with agrobacterium?
Today we're going to give them green fluorescent protein. This is the most common protein we use to tag specific molecules or cells. Interestingly, they are actually taken from marine animals like jellyfish, which are naturally fluorescent.
And this is a really great first gene to try for this type of experiment, right? Like it has a really obvious visual result. The plant is glowing green, like we know the transformation experiment works.
Yes,
like, yes.
You will see some. Right now we're going to expose the seedlings to the agrobacterium by submerging them into the agrobacterium transformation solution.
Oh, time for your bacteria bath. Can I try? I can't wait to transform some columbines. Okay.
Let's go, Molly.
So I just plunk them right in?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. I've been waiting 9 years for this, Yan.
That's exciting, isn't it?
Sound more excited for me. Look at all of our little seedlings and their bacteria bath. Okay, what's next?
Yes, now we're going to use this vacuum infiltrator to pull a very strong vacuum. This will allow the bacteria to be pulled into the tissue.
Okay, so just soaking in an agro bath isn't enough to do the transformation. You need to like use a vacuum to suck it, all the agro into the cells.
That's right. Otherwise, you only expose like your skin, and then not the internal tissues. Now I'm gonna turn on the vacuum infiltrator. You're gonna see magic.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Yes, now a lot of bacteria have been put inside the plant tissue, and you can tell this because the leaf color now is much green. And now we are halfway through.
This is so much easier than Vigs.
That's right.
Vigs was the very limited gene transformation tool we had before this, and it was the bane of my existence in grad school. Unlike Yan's protocol, which will result in an entire plant that is transformed and able to pass the transformation to its offspring, the best you could hope for with Vigs was a few flowers with PASHI transformation. The protocol was super labor intensive. I had to inject agrobacteria into hundreds of mature plants for weeks to get a result, and anytime I needed more flowers, I had to do it all over again. On top of that, you could only turn genes off. You couldn't add new genes like GFP. So yeah, that's why I am so excited about the transformation protocol that Yan's developing.
Okay, so now that our seedlings have had all their aggro vacuumed into them, what happens now?
Yes, now we're gonna take them out of the solution and then let them chill for a couple of days and let the bacteria do its magic. This process is basically like when you're baking a bread, you let the yeast sitting with the dough for a while.
Then you need to give them time to do their thing.
Yes. Now this is a batch I did transformation 2 days ago, and then they are done with their resting. Now I'm gonna chop them into pieces. And then those little pieces, with the help of a hormone, they can regenerate into the whole plants. They can make the whole plant body again. And this is a standard procedure that many transformation protocols rely on to make the transgenic plants.
The chop and the regeneration is classic. My turn?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Okay. The tiniest little chops. All done, chop it up for our
Angels. Now the pieces are resting on this, we call it regeneration media. Now we just need to sit around and wait. And be patient to let the plant babies do all the work.
And now we want to make a whole plant just from those little chopped up bits.
Yes, and then it's going to take several stages. The first stage, the hormone in this media are going to help them to form a specific type of tissue called the callus, as I'm showing here, which is from a transformation I did a month ago.
Oh my gosh, the callus is blobs.
Yes, they are a blob of cells, have the capacity to form plant, including the shoots and the roots again.
Oh, hey blobs, what's up?
Aren't they cute?
Yeah, they are cute.
And then the second stage, we are trying to help these little blobs to reform and reorganize and reform the shoot tissue, as you can see the green bits here, with the help of reduced plant hormones and our specific tools. We call them developmental genes, which we infiltrated together with the GFP when we did the transformation.
Oh, sneaky.
This is also where we differentiate ourselves from the traditional transformation methods.
Okay, so in order to get columbine specifically to be able to remember how to rebuild a plant from callus, you have to give it the help of additional developmental genes all the time whenever you do a transformation.
Yes, and this part is very tricky, and it's also where we struggle for the last 10 years.
So this is what you've been working on for so long, is like how to get over this bottleneck of not being able to get beyond the callus stage. Because we've always had the ability to like transform columbines with agrobacterium, but we've just never been able to get this blob of cells to become a plant again.
That's right. Some plants have very high regeneration capacities, like corn and rice, and some plants, like columbines, are very picky.
So we help them be less picky with this developmental gene.
Yes.
It was super helpful to see all the stages laid out together, like a science cooking show. But I really wanted to know how the plants that Yan and I transformed together turned out. Most importantly, are they gonna glow green from the GFP gene we added? I'd been waiting 9 years to transform columbines, so I had to come back a few weeks later to see the results with my own eyes.
Hi, Molly. Welcome back.
Oh, thank you. So what have our plants been up to?
Yes. So remember last time we did the transformation, we put two different genes into it, right? Mm-hmm. One is this developmental gene for differentiation, and the other one is fluorescent protein, which today we're going to use to screen for the positive ones, indicating that's the one being transformed.
So they'll glow green.
Yes, they will have a little glow. Okay. Are you ready to see it?
Yes. We have to turn off the lights?
Yes.
Go story time.
All let's right, go.
Let's go. Ooh, so spooky!
Close your eyes.
Okay.
Yep. Wow, did you see those little fluorescent babies?
Oh, wait, they're glowing like gems! But I was not expecting it to be this magical. A lot of them have...
Yes, we did a great job last time.
Glowy green. Yeah, we did. Oh my god, we did. That's right. We transformed some columbines. I can finally say, in my scientific career, I have transformed some columbines, finally. From looking at these blobs, we know the green ones are positive. That tells us they're good candidates to now put onto the new medium with all the hormonal signals, because having the green also means they probably have the developmental gene. And then once they go onto the media with all the right hormonal signals, they'll be able to regenerate shoots and roots properly with the help of these genes.
That's right. Now with this, it will really help us to put in various different genes of interest to help us to look at for the genes we care about, where they're gonna be expressed, when we overexpress or misexpress them, mm-hmm. what kind of phenotype?
Right.
And then that will help us to understand how those genes are function in this context. And now we have hundreds of genes to make to look at their function.
Which one are you most excited about? You study a lot of nectar genes, yes, right? Is that what you're going to be doing first?
Yeah, you will see in a couple of years. Take a long time.
Yes.
Well, I now have a sense of scientific closure that was many years in the making. I'm so glad that Ian finally figured out how to do this experiment. The Kramer Lab and other columbine flower scientists are going to do some truly cool research with this new technology, and I cannot wait to see the discoveries they make with it.